So in this example, we will design a vending machine which will deliver a package of gum. If 10 cents is deposited, it only accepts 5 cents. It does not accept any other money. So, and we have this input signal N, which becomes 1 when a nickel is deposited. And we have this output signal G, it becomes 1 when 10 cents is deposited, right? So if G is 1, right, we will deliver the package of gum, okay? And as always, we have this clock and reset signals as our inputs. So this is a very simple vending machine design. So the first step here, we need to determine our states, right? So what could be my states? My first state could be S0, meaning I have a 0 cent in my vending machine. And in this case, my output G will become 0. Another state could be S1. I have a 5 cents in the machine and my output is 0. And I have S2. I have 10 cents in my machine and my output will be 1. Okay? And I don't have any other state, right? You cannot have any state that has more than 10 cents, right? Because as soon as you reach this S2 state, your output will be 1, and then you need to go back to the S0 state. Okay, let's draw our state diagram. So this is my S0, and let's say I will have this reset signal. Once I get this reset signal, I will start from S0 state, and I will have S1 state and S2 state. So we can either do milli or moor. We can do both of them, but let's do moor here. And then you can also try to do milli, or we can just do it here. So in this case, if I am in S0 state, if the N signal is 1, then I will go to S1 state, right? If I am in S0 state, if the N is 0, then I will be staying in this state, right? So if I am in S1 state, if the N is 0, I will stay here. Right, and then if the N is 1, I will go to S2 state. So as soon as I reach S2, the next clock cycle, I need to go to S0 state. So this is N is 0 or N is 1. And then if this is a Moore state machine, I need to write my outputs inside the state. So in this case, my G is 0. So my G is 0, and my G is 1. In this case. Okay, now given this state diagram, we can also do our state table so that we can determine our next state logic. So our input is N, so we will assume that the reset is directly connected to our D flip-flops. Okay, therefore I will not include it in my state table. So my input is N, and then I have 3 states, right? So for 3 states, I can use 2 flip-flops. So I can say this is Q1 and Q0. So my present state will be Q1T and Q0T. And then we will try to determine our next state, Q1T plus 1 and Q0T plus 1. And then we will also determine our output G. So now let's write 8 possibilities for our input and present state. So if I am in S0 state, if my input is 0, my next state is S0 again. If I am in S1 state, if my input is 0, I will be also staying in the S1 state. This will be 0, 1. Okay, so if I am in S2 state, right, it doesn't matter if my input is 0 or 1, my next state will be 0, 0, right? So we don't have any 1, 1 case, so this will be a don't care for me. So we don't have this state. Okay, then let's go to input is 1, and if I am in 0, 0 state, then my next state will be 0, 1, S1 state. If I am in S1 state, my next state will be S2, 1, 0. If I am in S2 state, I will be going directly to 0, 0 state, right? And I don't have this 1, 1 state. I will have a don't care here. So the G is only 1 if my present state is 1, 0. So this is my present state 1, 0. So this will be 1. This will be 0, 0. And I will have a don't care here. I will have a don't care here. So this will be 0, this will be 0, and this will be 1 due to my present state is 1, 0, right? Okay, so given this, now we can determine our next state logic. Let's do it for Q1, T plus 1. Easier way of doing this is using a Carnot map. So given this Carnot map, can find out my Q1 T plus 1. So this is the one group that I can do. So this is N times Q0. So now let's do it for Q0 T plus 1. So the two groups that I can do. So this is one group. And then I need to take this by itself. So this will be N naught and T naught actually. Let's also correct this one. And Q0 T or NT Q1 T naught and Q0 T naught. So now we can draw our schematic for this circuit, right? So this is our next state logic, right? So we also need to find out our G. Actually, G is exactly equal to S2, right? You don't need to do this, but let's do it and then see. So I can group this here. So the G is equal to Q1 T. Okay. So this will be my output. So this is my output logic. So as you see, it does not depend on my input. It only depends on my state. So this is a Moore finite state machine. So let's do the Mealy version of this. So in this case, my states, so it will be S0 and S1 state. So this is 0 cents and this is 5 cents. And as soon as I have 5 cents, and if there is another 5 cents, I can go back to S0 state, I can deliver a GAM. So in this case, I don't need to have my S2. So this is my state diagram. So if there's a reset, I go to S0. If the N is 0, I stay here and my output is 0. If N is 1, then I go to S1 and my output is 0. So if in S1, if no nickel deposited, if N is 0, my G is still 0. But if there is a 5 cent deposited, I go back to S0. So this is my Mealy state diagram. So I have one less state in this case. So in this case, we have two states and then I will have one flip-flop. Okay, so I can write my state table. If I am in zero state, if the N is zero, my next state is zero. If N is zero, if my state is one, my next state will be still one. So if I am in S0 state and if my input is one, I will go to S1 state. So this will be one. If I am in S1 state and my input is 1, I'll go back to S0 state and my output will be 1 here and it will be 0 in all these cases. So Q2 plus 1 is NT XOR QT, right? And G is NT and QT, right? So if we draw this, so I have this D flip-flop here and I have only one of them. Let's say this is N. So I have an XOR gate here and this is Q XOR N here, and then I have this N and Q AND, and this will be my G, right? And this is my clock. So as you see, in this case, the Mealy finite state machine is much simpler than Moore, right? It has less components and it is easier to design compared to Moore. We have 4 AND gates, inverters, and 2 flip-flops. But in the Mealy, we have only 1 AND gate, 1 XOR gate, and 1 flip-flop.